subhanahu wa ta'ala warns us once again regarding our tongues. And he's worded it so beautifully. O you who believe, be conscious of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and utter only that which is upright. Only speak that which is sadid. Sadid means straight. That which is the truth. That which is upright. That which is free from any form of vulgarity and abuse. That which will result in a person's Jannah and paradise, or goodness in this world as well as the next. When we speak that which is truthful, when we are careful of how we say what we want to say, then by the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, Yuslih lakum a'malakum. Your deeds that you've been engaging in, He will purify them, or He will make them correct or good. Good enough to be accepted by Allah. And why this is the case? There are so many examples or explanations. One of them is, when we've done a lot of good deeds, but we're not bothered about what we say. We lie, we cheat, we deceive, we slander, we spread rumor, we engage in very bad words with our mouths, we scream and yell, we abuse people. In that case, all the acts of worship we've engaged in shall be wasted, because they will be paid as a payment to those whom we have wronged with our tongue. This is why we need to be careful. If we are careful with what we say, then our deeds that we engage in, we will protect them. We will look after them. When we come on the day of judgment, we won't have to pay them to anyone and give them as a penalty. So this is why Allah says, when you are careful regarding what comes out from your mouth, we will make your other deeds, inshallah, we will make your other deeds good enough or pure or acceptable, and we will forgive your sins. And he ends the verses by saying, whoever follows Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger, they have indeed succeeded. They are victorious in a very, very great way. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us success and victory.